Hello everyone and welcome to this webinar about the ST60 transceiver for contactless connectivity. My name is Fabrice Gendreau and I'm the marketing manager for the EMEA region. I'm very pleased to be with you today to talk about our latest ST60 transceiver, which is a millimeter wave product that delivers very high data rates for short-range contactless connectivity applications. Here is the agenda of today's webinar. I will start with a brief introduction regarding the positioning of ST60 in wireless technologies, followed by its key product features and performances characteristics, and then I will discuss how the ST60 can be implemented in a contactless Ethernet solution. My colleagues Jérôme and Tariq will then demonstrate two real use cases, the first involving a contactless Ethernet module developed by one of our partners, and the second using our dedicated evaluation kit with various antenna configurations. And finally, I will describe the key benefits of the ST60 and how you can quickly begin evaluating its performances and potential. We will wrap up with an interactive Q&A session. Let's begin by exploring how the ST60 compares with other wireless connectivity strategies and the new world of possibilities that this technology offers. We introduced this very recent addition to ST's portfolio for the first time at Embedded World in 2019. So, what is ST60? In short, it is a very low-power transceiver operating on a carrier frequency of 60 GHz, which is in the unlicensed V-band. It delivers very high data communication rates ranging from a few kilobits per second up to 6.25 gigabits per second and can pass through materials such as plastic and wood, but not conductive materials. From the onset, the ST60 was designed to offer industry lowest power per bit. Here we have two charts. The chart on the left shows data throughput versus power consumption, and on the right, the change in throughput with distance. Both charts compare the performances of the ST60 with several common wireless connectivity technologies such as WiGig, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and NFC. Returning to the first chart, you can see that the power consumption of our transceiver is comparable with Bluetooth, even though Bluetooth has a far lower data transmission rate. So the ST60 clearly wins this contest in terms of performances and power budget. The second chart on the right side shows how the various connectivity technologies perform over operating ranges. So you can see that the ST60 delivers high-speed performance for short-distance data communication up to 10 cm. In this sense, it is comparable with NFC, but able to support much higher data rates, up to 6.25 gigabits per second. In short, this new solution enables high-speed, low-power, short-range, point-to-point contactless connectivity and is an ideal replacement for all the cables and connectors used in board-to-board or device-to-device data communication, which we all know can cause failures and are burdens on manufacturing cost and design complexity. The new ST60 can greatly simplify many design challenges involving waterproof, corrosive-proof, and dust-proof operation in hermetically sealed environments while maintaining high-speed data links. Let's examine some real solutions the ST60 can offer by replacing wired connection in high-speed data applications. One highly successful application is LED displays, which you find in indoor and outdoor environments, in stadiums, in office buildings, and in airports. Multiple LED display modules are normally connected through Ethernet cables and connectors to build a display wall. With the ST60, you can build a full plug-and-play type solution and replace Ethernet cables and connectors with contactless video links, hence removing the on-site work required to connect the LED modules, improving reliability, and cutting costs. In personal electronics applications like smartphones and wearables, the ST60 can replace all the connectors for internal board-to-board communication and external device-to-device communication. These benefits can be combined with wireless power transfer solutions from ST to develop truly waterproof, dustproof, and connector-free products for end users. In industrial systems heavily exposed to harsh environments or mechanical stresses which could compromise wire connections, the ST60 allows greater freedom of movement with contactless data links that are far more robust against environmental and operating conditions, including shock, vibration, and rotation, as well as protecting sensitive electronic devices by providing natural galvanic isolation. In factory automation, imagine simply placing a product on a programmer or vice versa to immediately establish a connection and start exchanging data, for example, to flash or test a product during manufacturing. The ST60 can solve many issues requiring robust data transmission and therefore increase manufacturing reliability and productivity. Now let's have a look at the key features and performances of the ST60. Here you see the block diagram and some key features. The ST60 is a fully integrated transceiver operating in the 60 GHz V-band. It is a highly integrated and compact design with transmit and receive paths, digital control and power management with single or dual power supply in a very small footprint. Dual supply offers slightly lower power consumption, while single supply offers a more straightforward implementation. The device can be configured through either an I2C bus or directly through hardware control pins, which is the easiest way to set the direction and the operating mode. The point-to-point wireless link connectivity operates in half duplex mode using the highly effective amplitude shift key modulation scheme, with about 24 dB typical total link budget. The device supports either a single-ended CMOS I/O interface for data transfer from a few kilobits per second to 100 megabits per second, or differential SLVS TRX ports for data transfer up to 6.25 gigabits per second. The device features exceptional power management, consuming 40 mW in full transmit mode at 5 gigabits per second, 25 mW in receive mode, and only 1.3 microwatt in off mode. It comes in a very small VIBGA 2.2 by 2.2 mm package and offers a reduced bill of materials because there is no need for external RF components, no balloon, no matching network, and no external reference clock. The only thing it requires is an antenna, which I will detail in the following slide. The ST60 can be configured through either the I2C bus or hardware control pins to support different operating modes and data rate modes. Three configurations are available. Two using the SLVS differential input-output port TRX-RX, which needs to be DC balanced and 8-bit 10-bit data coded to enable either full data rate mode from 1 megabit per second up to 5 gigabits per second, or high data rate mode from 500 megabits per second up to 6.25 gigabits per second. This mode is usually used only for data rates above 5 gigabits per second. The typical application shown in the block diagram implements two ST60 devices on each side, with SLVS connected to the Ethernet HDMI interface to form a contactless gigabit Ethernet link. Note that if customer wants to use FDR or HDR modes, the ST60 must be connected with a host device that supports the SLVS or LVDS interface. For example, FPGA or HDMI gigabit Ethernet PHY. The last configuration is using the single-ended CMOS I/O to enable low data rate mode from 9.6 kilobit per second up to 100 megabit per second. The typical application shown in the block diagram implements two ST60 devices on each side, with CMOS I/O connected to the UARTX RX of a microcontroller to enable contactless full duplex UARTs without a cable and without altering any lines of code. For the antenna, the ST60 supports three different antenna configurations depending on the distance and coupling requirements of your application. The antenna on board, or patch antenna configuration pictured in the middle, is embedded on the PCB using very inexpensive FR4 material. It supports a free space distance of 1.5 cm to 3 cm depending on the data rate mode. The patch antenna delivers vertical communication and is typically suitable for device-to-device connectivity with one device on top of the other. For horizontal communication, then we have something called the horn antenna, pictured on the right. These horn antennas have been developed in partnership with a company named Radial. They are mounted directly onto the surface of the PCB and are compatible with pick-and-place processes. The higher gain makes it suitable for free space distance of 3 cm to 5 cm. These antennas are available in either vertical or horizontal polarization, so they are very suitable for multilink applications thanks to the isolation between H and V polarized signals, typically to enable full duplex link. The final antenna in package configuration shown on the left is directly integrated into the ST60 package. It offers the smallest form factor, but the lower gain mean it is only suitable for very short distance in the order of a few millimeters. Can be used for board-to-board communication in a device or to provide galvanic isolation in a board. In the next set of slides, I will focus on a typical application of the ST60 involving contactless Ethernet communication. More and more applications require Ethernet-based connections, but the Ethernet RJ45 connector is not robust to numerous plug-unplug or mating cycles and not resistant to corrosive elements, dust, liquids, and similar environmental conditions. This has generated wide interest in removing the RJ45 connector, which is where the ST60 comes in. An application that makes extensive use of Ethernet connection is to connect multiple LED display modules in a wall display and transmit the video stream to the different parts of the display. We know that Ethernet cables and connectors add cost and complexity to the production and assembly of the wall display. The ST60 resolves these issues, and as most of the time there is already an FPGA on board, the cost can be further reduced by eliminating the Ethernet file and connecting the SLVS input-output port of the ST60 directly to the FPGA. In factory automation, the ST60 allows full 360 degrees movement freedom, which can be particularly beneficial for industrial robots whose movements are often restricted to avoid damaging the many cables and connectors crossing the different joints. The ST60 therefore provides a wireless bridge across the different parts of a robot. In industrial and security cameras, contactless Ethernet communication can allow plug-and-play modules, again eliminating the need for expensive high-speed data cables and connectors and readability issues caused by things like cable rotation. It also makes devices more compact, smaller and slimmer thanks to the removal of the cables and RJ45 connectors. Finally, the ST60 allows a new kind of contactless, hermetically sealed Ethernet connectors to replace costly IP6X connectors, eliminating the need of expensive Ethernet file and magnetics, especially in 2.5 gigabit per second or 5 gigabit per second Ethernet links, and making Ethernet connections modular and sealed. This is the block diagram of a potential configuration to replace an Ethernet cable connecting a PC on the left to a server on the right. Both sides have onboard RJ45 connectors, as well as a gigabit Ethernet PHY with native HDMI interface support, connected directly to two ST6C through the SLVS input-output ports. You need two devices in parallel on each side to enable a full duplex link with separate transmit and receive paths, as a single ST6C can only support half duplex operation. This configuration enables a gigabit contactless Ethernet full duplex link supporting 10, 100 and 1000 megabits per second. It does not require a clock on the TX or RX side, and the actual clock data recovery is provided through the Ethernet PHY. It is available in antenna on board configuration for vertical transmission and on antenna for horizontal transmission. Depending upon the antenna configuration, the Ethernet signal can be transmitted up to a distance of a few centimeters. The Ethernet protocol handles all connection issues, such as broken links, so data transmission errors can be detected and resent. The use of a 5 gigabit per second PHY can be used to create a 5 gigabit per second connection in the same way. If you want to quickly begin evaluating contactless Ethernet connectivity, then you can use this SK202A and B modules with the horn antenna. These modules were developed by EPS in China in partnership with Radial for the horn antennas. Each module consists of a main board hosting the RJ45 connector, the magnetic transformer and the gigabit Ethernet PHY with HDMI interface. An RF daughter board hosting two ST60 and two horn antennas with H and V polarization is soldered on the motherboard. If we zoom on the RF boards, you can see that the polarization of the horn antennas is inverted on each board. Your final application should integrate the RF board components directly onto the main PCB for cost-saving purposes, and ST provides design guidelines to help you build your integrated solution. Alternatively, you can source the module directly from EPS. The second version of the module implements antenna on board with exactly the same features as the first set, but designed for vertical communication, so that you have the two boards sitting on top of each other to enable the link, as shown on the picture. In these modules made by EPS, the horn antennas are replaced with two single patch protein board antennas, as shown on the left side. The rest remains the same, with RJ45 connector, magnetic transformer, and gigabit Ethernet PHY with HDMI interface to connect to the ST60 devices. Now we shall pass over to Jérôme for the first hands-on demo of these contactless Ethernet modules.
Okay, thank you Fabrice for your introduction. Now let's switch to the module himself. So this is two flavor of the module, of the Ethernet module done by our partner, which is EPS. And the first one, which is 202, for horizontal transmission, come with a horn antenna. So this is a, so it's sent from this to this, and then back to using this antenna. And for vertical transmission, we are using the second flavor, which is 201, and with a patch antenna. ST60 is there, so it's quite small, it's 2 by 2 millimeters, and we have one for sending and one for receiving. Okay, now let's switch to the setup using a real Ethernet cable to show you the performance, and then we will show exactly the same setup using ST60 to see the magic. Okay, so here you have a STM32 MP1 board, which is running a network drive on it with some content into SD card. And I will transfer the content of this SD card using the gigabit network cable to the laptop. As you can see, we have 200 megabits transfer from the MP1 to the laptop. Again, it's limited by the SD card himself. Okay, so now I will show you the latency of the network from the laptop to the MP1. So the latency is quite low, it's around 1 millisecond. And the third step is to show you, since we have seen we have some limitation due to SD card for throughput transfer, so I will use another tool which is called iPerf, which is a standard tool. And I have an iPerf server which is running on the board. I have an iPerf client which is running on this laptop. I will show you gigabit transfer in between. So, as you can see, we are close to 900 megabits per second. Okay, remember the APS module? So we have a nice casing for this, and we have some magnet to have some contactless Ethernet module. So due to demo constraints and to limit the amount of cable on the demo, I put some battery in it just for demo purpose, but this is the same module. Let's set up the magic. So I will just plug my first Ethernet module to the laptop, and so I remove the previous cable which is go to MP1. So now this module is connected to the laptop, and I will use this cable to connect the second module. Okay, so now we have introduced the Ethernet module with SC60, and I've made no modification, no hardware modification, so I will show you the three steps I've made just before. So the first one was to transfer a file from the MP1 to the laptop. Second step was to show latency, network latency, and the latest one was throughput. Let's start by the beginning with file transfer. So we have exactly the same throughput with ST60. And as you can see, when I open, it stops, and then it back to transfer. So now I will show you network latency. So as you can see, it's close to 1 millisecond, same as before. And if I open longer, so it stops, and it's back just after. Okay, first step is to show you so high throughput, so using iPerf3 again. So again, so we are close to 900 megabits, and again, if I open the network, it stops, and back again. Okay, so now I will demonstrate a video playback. So the content is still on this MP1 board. It go through ST60 and then to my laptop. So I use the standard tool VLC. So media open. I remove a bit caching and then I select my file and then send my playback. Okay, so now the content is played through Ethernet module. And then if I open the link, it stops playback. Okay, now if I restore the link, thanks to Ethernet protocol, which handle broken link, playback is now continuing directly. Now I can open a bit, few centimeters, to see that it's still working. And that will use several material. Cardboard first. No impact. Plastic. Again, no impact. Plexiglass. And then metalized pipe, which block the signal. So as expected, you can see that it stopped everything. And if I remove it, it will start audio first and then back to video. Thank you.
Thank you, Jérôme. Besides the contactless Ethernet modules, which are more application-oriented, ST also provides this ST60 evaluation kit designed for RF evaluations and measurements. This versatile evaluation kit supports all the available modes, from the low data rate mode using the single-ended CMOS I/O to the full data rate and high data rate modes using the SLVS differential input-output port. The kit consists of a B2265 motherboard hosting all the input-output SMA connectors to connect to RF equipments, and a configuration jumper if you wish to configure the ST60 by hardware. You can also interface this board with STM32 Nucleo boards in order to configure the ST60 through the I2C bus. This motherboard is compatible with different ST60 RF modules supporting the different antenna configurations, integrated, patch or on antennas, and with single or dual ST60 for half duplex or full duplex communication. This evaluation kit is mainly to allow users obtain measurements for eye diagrams, bit error rates, and jitter, depending on distance between the antennas and the material in between, free air, plastic, glass, etc. Here is a view of the multiple RF antenna modules we provide to let you evaluate board-to-board communication, combining antenna in package or antenna on board or on antennas with the typical distances you can achieve. Note that you can combine antenna in package with antenna on board or antenna in package with on antenna to slightly increase the distance versus two antennas in package. The longest possible distance is achieved when combining on antenna with on antenna. Please note that the distances are estimated at 1.25 gigabit per second. We recommend starting the evaluation kit in hardware first mode, and here you can see the typical configuration of the jumpers and the signal paths to be used to evaluate the low data rate mode on the left side, using the 6WKP single-ended CMOS I/O for data transfer up to 100 Mbps, and the high data rate mode on the right side, using the differential SLVS TRX RX input output ports for data transfer up to 6.25 gigabit per second. Now I pass over to Tariq for the second on-zone demo using our evaluation kit.
Thank you, Fabrice, and thanks everyone for joining. In this short video, we will make two measurements on the ST60A2 evaluation kit. But first, let's have a look at the ST60A2 boards offered by ST. We have adopted a modular approach with optimized form factor RF reference boards to be plugged on evaluation boards. This approach allows us to switch between RF reference boards and enables you to connect them on your development board in a prototyping phase, for example. We can see here the RF reference boards we have developed so far. Thanks to our partner Radial, we've got horn antennas which radiate in parallel with the PCB. Here's a full duplex ref board with two ST60A2s in simplex mode and opposite directions. With the same horn antennas, here's a half duplex ref board with a single ST60A2. Here is a half duplex ref board with an onboard antenna for transmission perpendicular to the PCB plane. Finally, this is a half duplex ref board with an antenna integrated in the ST60A2 package, saving space on the board. And these are two evaluation boards on which, as mentioned earlier, we can plug any of the RF reference boards. This one is for LDR mode, which stands for low data rate mode, and it allows the evaluation of data transmission of 1.8 volt single-ended signals with data rate going from 9600 bits per second to 100 megabits per second. LDR mode would be the configuration for the transmission of UART or other application-specific control signals, for example. This bigger board can be used to evaluate all the features of the ST60A2, like the LDR mode I just mentioned, as well as differential mode. This differential mode enables the transmission of data with rates from 1 megabits per second up to 625 gigabits per second. This data rate corresponds to higher speed signals such as 1 gigabit Ethernet, USB SS, V/1, or 5 gigabit Ethernet. So, a full evaluation kit is composed of four boards. Two evaluation boards on which two RF reference boards are plugged. With this, we can validate the ref board and the transmission link performances, and you can also develop your application. So, let's have a closer look at the bigger board, because we are gonna use it in our measurements. The ref board is plugged here. The differential data to be transmitted will come through these two connectors, and the received data will go through these ones. LDR data to be transmitted is fed through this connector, and this one is for the received data. The board is powered here and needs a 3.3 volt supply. The ST60A2 can be operated in standalone mode, which we call hardware forced, where the transfer mode is selected using a bootstrap and no programming is needed. The transfer mode configuration is done through these jumpers, and three transfer modes can be selected. The LDR mode, which I mentioned before. Then there is the FDR mode, standing for full data rate, for SLVS data transfer with rates from 1 megabits per second to 5 gigabits per second. And finally, the HDR mode, or high data rate mode, which enables us to transfer SLVS data up to 6.25 gigabits per second. The ST60A2 can also be operated in I2C mode with full access to the device's registers. It is possible to connect the board via these Arduino connectors with an STM32 Nucleo board, which is used to run a GUI dedicated to ST60A2 register settings. So, let's jump into the demonstration now. We will first do an eye diagram and jitter measurement in HDR mode. Here is our evaluation kit. It's configured in HDR mode. One board will transmit the signal and the second will receive it. Let's configure our signal generator. The voltage settings fit the ST60A2's SLVS specification. That is 200 mV amplitude on each line, centered on 200 mV, which means a differential signal amplitude of 400 mV over 100 ohms differential impedance. Here I am selecting the data pattern. In differential mode and starting from 100 megabits per second, the ST60A2 needs to work on 8-bit, 10-bit coded data to guarantee a balanced distribution of zeros and ones. Here we select PRBS7 sequence as it has similar properties as 8-bit 10-bit coded data. Now we finish with the data rate setting. Let's test 6.25 gigabits per second, which is the maximum supported by the ST6082. This data rate corresponds to the 5 gigabit Ethernet to which an 8-bit 10-bit coding would be added. It also corresponds to the rate of the RZOE interface, which carries 10 gigabit Ethernet over two 6.25 gigabits per second lanes. Now that the generator is configured, let us connect it to the transmit evaluation board. On the receiver side, we connect the evaluation board's output to an oscilloscope for an eye diagram and jitter analysis. Please note that it is essential to make sure that the oscilloscope and probe's characteristics, such as bandwidth and sampling rate, are compatible with the data rate of the signal you want to analyze. One last comment about the cables used here. It is essential that you make sure that they are compatible with the frequencies you want to test. Check the VSWR and insertion loss, and make sure to use matched cables in order not to introduce skew between the positive and negative lengths. We are now ready to make our measurement, and I am going to use the oscilloscope's automated setup. While the oscilloscope does the measurement, I'd like to add that you could also measure bit error rate instead of or in addition to jitter. BER measurement takes longer time to make. It's up to you to choose whether to make BER or jitter measurement. It can be depending on the specification you have, whether you have a jitter mask or a bit error rate limit. Back to our measurement, and I see that we've already got the result. The oscilloscope displays many waveforms and figures, including the jitter distribution and the eye diagram, which as you can see is wide open for a 6.25 gigabits per second data rate and about 12 millimeter space between the antennas. We also get the total jitter, around 52 picoseconds here, and its components, so you can have a look at the random jitter and deterministic jitter. You may want to transmit the signal through plastic, so let's see how the jitter evolves when there is some plastic between the two antennas. The signal power received by the antenna decreased because it's been attenuated while passing through the 2 millimeter thick piece of plastic, and this leads to a different eye diagram and a bigger jitter. Here 58 picoseconds, 6 picoseconds more than previous result. Let's now make a measurement in LDR mode. I will show you a latency measurement, which is an important parameter to compare between different solutions and connectivity standards. Okay, I need to change the setup. Select LDR mode, use a different generator, set the data rate to 1 megabit per second, the voltage swing to 1.8 volt. I have connected the generator output to the evaluation kit's input port. On the oscilloscope, I connected a copy of the transmitted signal and the received signal. Let's measure the time difference with the received signal. Here we see it is in the 9 nanoseconds range. Ideally, I would recommend measuring the latency of the test setup without the device and then subtracting it from this result to get an accurate value. It is just for the sake of the demo that we are keeping it simple today. I've used cables of the same length, so I'm measuring the latency of the evaluation kit from one connector to another. This measurement done this way gives us already a fair idea on the ST6082 latency, around 8 nanoseconds. This is all that I wanted to show you today. So what are the main takeaways of this video? ST's ST6082 evaluation kit offer is varied, and you have a wide choice from which you can order one for your application. I've demonstrated that the ST6082 can transmit data at a rate of 6.25 gigabits per second without problem, proving that we are compatible with standard high data rate transmission schemes. You can use our boards for performance evaluation and check jitter, BER versus data rate, propagation distance and medium. For sure, this should always be done with respect to a target specification. Very small latency is one of the key features of the ST6082 versus other wireless standards.
Thank you, Tariq. We are now close to the end, and I would like to summarize the key points related to this new technological solution enabling contactless connectivity. The most important benefit of the ST60 is obviously its cable-like contactless connectivity. While it provides the same performance as cable connectivity in terms of data rate, jitter and ping, it offers greater reliability than cables and connectors, lower cost, and much greater robustness against harsh environmental and operating conditions. The ST60 supports very high-speed data communication up to 6.25 gigabit per second, making it suitable to replace the widely used gigabit Ethernet-based communication. One ST60 base link can replace 5 Ethernet links at 1 gigabit per second. The device comes in both consumer and extended industrial temperature ranges from minus 40 degrees Celsius to plus 105 degrees Celsius. It supports several antenna configurations for side-by-side or top-bottom data transmission, and there is also a version with integrated antenna. And finally, it is cost-optimized in terms of bill of materials, with no need for external RF components, and a miniature footprint of less than 5 square millimeters. To summarize, the ST60 opens a new world of possibilities for your product design by enabling high speed, low power, short range, point-to-point contactless connectivity. Here is what you can do to get started with the ST60. The ST60 A2 product brief is freely available on ST website, together with a short overview. And there are three very good videos on YouTube. The first from ST Online Embedded World Tour 2020, which demonstrates the contactless gigabit Ethernet connection using the EPS modules. The second one from ST at Consumer Electronics Show 2020, which demonstrates ST60 application in LED display modules. And the third one from ST at Embedded World 2019, that demonstrates wireless UART through a plastic box. The above resources will provide a good overview of this product and how it can be used in various types of industrial, medical, and consumer applications. You can then progress to performance evaluation and application development, and ST can provide comprehensive supporting materials, including full datasheet, user manual, antenna design guidelines, evaluation kits and samples under a non-disclosure agreement. In this case, please contact either your local ST sales representative or myself, and I will be very pleased to support you. I would like to thank you all very much for your attention, and I hope that this presentation has provided you with a better idea of the key features and benefits of this new solution.